The Philippine government launches an online platform for better data access to Filipinos. Our correspondent Jackie Pascual is on the line for the details. Jackie?
Hi, Denise. The Philippine Statistics Authority has made it easier for students, data analysts, and the public in general to research and collect information. The agency has launched its enhanced website, the PSA Data Archive, and Digital Library. National Statistician Undersecretary Claire Dennis Mapa said the improved psa.gov.ph is now mobile-friendly and has more features to help those seeking data. The Data Archive and Digital Library also make it easier to search and read information. Almost all the studies, the surveys, and research collected and written by PSA researchers the past years can be viewed and downloaded by students, the academe, journalists, politicians, and the public. These include publications published decades ago up to the current surveys PSA has done. For example, Denise, data includes topics about labor, health, population, OFW, poverty, housing, the economy, and many more. PSA said it's very important for Filipinos to access data as research can help beef up the economy in the long run, and it can pave way for a more data-driven policy and push for knowledge and research exchange. More features may be added in the future as PSA reviews and upgrades its system to help the public gain access to vital information about the country. And that's the latest. Denise, back to you.
Thanks, Jackie.
The Philippine Budget Department on the defensive over the increase in confidential and intelligence funds in the 2024 spending plan. Budget Secretary Amena Pangandaman says this is due to additional confidential funds for agencies like the ICT Department, the Anti-Money Laundering Council, and the Presidential Security Group. The proposed 9.2 billion pesos in CIF for next year is 120 million pesos more compared to this year. But Pangandaman says it's actually smaller in terms of the total share in the 5.77 trillion peso proposed budget for 2024. Next year's spending plan, though, is about 9.5% higher compared to this year's 5.27 trillion peso budget.
In 2018 po, ang share po ng CIF sa total national budget is 0.215%. 2023, 0.190%. And sa 2024 po, it's only 0.176%. So it's the lowest po dun sa time series natin. So ibig sabihin po yung share po niya dun sa kabuuang budget natin, while you look at it, it's 10 billion pesos, it's actually ano po, decreasing naman po. Percentage. I think what it's important is that yung other sector na tumataas, yung confidential and intel mo bumababa. When you look at the budget, you look at the share of the different sectors dun sa total budget mo. So pag nakikita mo lumalaki yung social services, economic sector, and maybe general and yung defense, okay siya, di ba, compared to your CIF.
Pangandaman also calling the 1.4 billion budget proposal for the president's trips next year justified.
Yung travel po ng presidente, dalawa pong klase yan. Meron pong state visit that they invite you. And then meron din po yung mga investment roadshow. So I think yung expenses po ng travel, it will be beneficial and mas may advantage po para sa bansa natin, I think okay lang po yun.
More than 100 local companies are accused of various tax violations amounting to 6.1 billion pesos. That is the result of the Philippine Tax Bureau's second nationwide filing under its Run After Tax Evaders program. The agency says it has filed criminal charges against 214 corporate executives for failing to file income taxes, withholding taxes, and value-added tax returns. But it did not disclose the names of the companies involved. The agency says this should serve as a warning for every corporation and officer not to ignore their tax obligations. The latest local bond issuance of State-Owned Development Bank of the Philippines raises 3.8 billion pesos in fresh funds. DBP President and CEO Michael De Jesus says the bank's 1.5-year fixed-rate series for bond issuance reached more than 3.6 times the announced minimum issue size of 2 billion pesos. The latest bonds were offered at par value with an interest rate of 6.41% per annum and are set to mature in January 2025. The funds would be channeled to various developmental projects and initiatives for key priority sectors. The United Nations Weather Office warns the El Niño phenomenon's negative impact on global agriculture production this year. The World Meteorological Organization earlier declared that El Niño conditions have developed in the tropical Pacific for the first time in 7 years, setting the stage for a possible surge in global temperatures as well as disruptive weather and climate patterns. El Niño usually lasts 9 to 12 months and can trigger changes in the weather, such as flooding in normally dry areas and drought in countries that usually receive adequate amount of rain.
They vary a lot between year to year, and the effect they have on different parts of the world varies as well. So we don't yet know how strong this one will be. As the El Niño develops, there will be different parts of the world will experience the impacts differently. So for some parts of the world, there could be drought associated with El Niño. And so the impact of drought clearly is not good on agriculture. And so for communities that can do so, they would need to consider irrigating their crops. Other parts of the world could experience floods, and so depending on the severity of the floods, that could also impact agriculture. It could destroy crops.
The Senate Blue Ribbon Committee calls out alleged irregularities at the National Irrigation Administration. As Ada Perez tells us, these include decades-long unfinished projects and funding requests for the maintenance of stalled works.
Rinaldo from Tribong Abiling was 18 years old when the construction of Balog-Balog Dam started in their area in Tarlac. He is now 57 years old, and this project of the National Irrigation Administration remains unfinished.
So actually, wala pa pong nangyayari sa Balog-Balog Dam. At sa totoo lang po, Balog-Balog Dam na sinasabi ay may pondo ng 13.37 bilyon. Pero ang ginawa ko lang nila, pinagbabakbak lang kalikasan namin, kinabunan po lang mga sagradong lugar. Yung mga pangako nila na nasa provision ng mga, ay halos hindi pa po naipatupad. Nung una po, sigasip po silang nagbibigay ng kabayaran ng anong mga plan damages, yung anong na-disturbant compensation. Bandang hindi, pinahirapan na po yung aking mga tao dahil marami na po silang hinahanap na dutubang.
Senator Raffy Tulfo said the Balog-Balog Dam project goes way back from the time of former President Corazon Aquino. It was intended to provide year-long irrigation for more than 34,000 hectares in 10 municipalities to benefit 23,000 farmers.
Ito po ang litrato ng auto inspection namin sa Balog-Balog. Ayan po, makikita nyo. Ito po ang itsura ng 12 billion pesos. Ayan ang itsura ng 12 billion pesos na proyekto na hanggang ngayon ay nakatiwangwang. Ang nakakatawa po dyan ay ginagastusan ito ng 50 million pesos a year sa repair and maintenance. Hindi pa nga po tapos. And yet, may 50 million pesos para sa maintenance. Ulitin ko po, 50 billion pesos na nagastos at nakatiwang lang at hindi pa tapos. E 50 million pesos para sa maintenance. Anong i-maintain? Ang mga bulsa?
NIA explained the project has been terminated with its former contractor.
Bumalik po kasi kami sa NEDA dahil may mga change sa may pinalit change of scope po yung trabaho. And then malapit na naman pong ipa-rebid po ulit ito. Within siguro ang target namin sir is around mga October siguro.
You confirm na 20% lang yung completion?
Well, ang ma-confirm ko lang po
after 5 decades.
Nung tinignan ko po mahigit pa pong 5 billion yung natitirang pondo. Enough naman po ito para tapusin yung high dam natin.
But lawmakers ask, why do unfinished projects need a maintenance budget? NIA officials provided different answers.
Alam ko po kasi, yung mga maintenance na yon, meron na po mga to upkeep yung mga irrigation facilities na mga na-complete po nila. No? May mga partially na ginagamit na po kasi. Yung phase 1 po, sir, na ginagamit po.
Yung pong kabuuan ng allocation ng project, hindi po yan ibinibigay ng one time. Hindi po yan pang-maintain. Yung pong mga requirement na every year allocation ng mga multi-year project.
Aside from Balog-Balog Dam, Tulfo said there are other unaccomplished projects like the 990 million peso Bulo Small Reservoir Irrigation Project in Bulacan, 650 million peso Marime Project in Apayao, and 800 million peso Dumulok Project in Pangasinan.
Katapos itong hearing, ipaglalaban ko na may makukulong.
The Senate is set to conduct more hearings on the issue. Ara Perez, ABS-CBN News.